Hello and welcome, you crazy cycling lovers. My name is Ruslan Mikhailyan and you're watching Skinny Spinners YouTube channel. Today we are back to Austria, Tour de Kärnten 2019 fourth stage, epic stage, hard stage, wet stage. But before we dive into the race, as usual, make sure to subscribe to my channel if you like this video, give it thumbs up, click on the bell notification button in order to receive messages from YouTube and emails whenever the new video comes. It really helps the channel, so will be highly appreciated. Traditionally we start in Osijek, of course, going along the Osijek Sea. Here in Treffen, the official starts point, and then slight incline all the way to Feld am See. After that, descent all the way to Dobrich, where the first climb of the day starts, and it's pretty epic. After that, downhill to Fritritz under Drau. Drau is the river, my god. After that, climb to Zlan. This is pretty flat, windy part that ends in the town with the name Mittewald ob Villach, and after that the long and winding climb to Bad Bleiberg starts, and it's a very epic climb, very hard, with highest gradients of about 20% or so. It's gonna kill you, kill your legs, gonna make you suffer, so you better be prepared. Let's go. Today's stage is 93 kilometers long. Finished it in 2 hours 56 minutes with the average speed of 31.5 kilometers per hour. Dude, this is fast. Total elevation gain is about 1500 meters. The highest heart rate I got was 182 beats per minute, and it was during the final sprint. Not bad, considering the fact that this is the fourth day and everybody is pretty tired. The maximum average wattage per 20 minutes was 223 watts. This is about 95% of mine critical power. What else? The average wattage 165 watts and the maximum I got 855. Epic. Official start over here. Going full gas from the start, we're making sure that we bridge across to group A. It's like 50 to 70 meters in front of us. You can see that we're closing it in 10 seconds or so. And now imagine this huge bunch of around 400 people, all the groups A, B, C, D, going with the speed of 30 to 50 kilometers per hour on these narrow roads. Pretty crazy. The first 10 kilometers was a small incline, around 1-3% gradient, so I had to make sure that I'm riding in the bunch, saving the energy for the hard climbs ahead, avoiding any crashes because it was pretty wet and hectic. Then 20 kilometers slight downhill all the way to Dobrich, to the first climb of the day, and during this 20 kilometers I tried to move as much as possible up the bunch in order to be somewhere in the head of the bunch. As you can see here, I'm doing not a good thing because I'm riding on the left side of the road, but I took my chances and I made it. Actually, I don't recommend doing it in Tour de Kärnten because the officials can be very strict and you can be disqualified or penalted or so. But in any case, you can see 600 to 700 watts, small sprint, and I made it to the first 50 or 60 riders, which is pretty good. So here it is, the first climb of the day, starting in Dobrich, finishing in Glans, around 3.5 kilometers with the average gradient of maybe 9-10%. I averaged 250 watts with the cadence of 86. It started to rain, the temperature was about 10 degrees Celsius or so, comfortable, except of course the rain. I tried to move up as much as possible just to make sure not to be caught in this traffic jams, because the people are blocking you sometimes and it's not really good, because you have your own pace, you have your own temper that you don't want to interrupt. Check out this guy on the left, just a washing machine, Froomey style, cadence over 120, I guess. Also, I kept in mind that I had around 50 kilometers to go, so I didn't wanna overdo it on the first climb. I was holding around 250-260 watts. I'm not going into red zone, which is pretty important in such cases. So this is like a small tip from Skinny Spinner. Another small tip from me: during such rainy, wet and cold stages, you gotta make sure that you drink properly and you drink enough water or easy drinks, whatever you have in your bottle, because if you don't, you can end up like Matthew Van Der Poel in World Championships. 10-15 kilometers to go, you have cramps, you hit the wall, your legs are empty, and this is not very good. You gotta drink even though you're not thirsty, and you gotta eat even though you feel that you are not hungry. One of the switchbacks over here, you can see going on the left side of the road over here, just because there are not a lot of cars. There is one car actually over here, but patiently waiting for us to pass, which you can rarely find in Ukraine. In Austria it's pretty common thing, which is really highly appreciated. This is the first downhill of the day. You can see that it's not raining anymore, however the road is still pretty wet, and you gotta be careful riding on these white road markings, especially while turning left to right. The reason is that it's pretty slippery and you can easily slide off the road. So in such cases, just be concentrated, focused and very careful. Today I'm not risking it, and the reason is that I almost crashed last time. You remember it from the last video, so you can see I'm playing it safe. A lot of riders are overtaking me because they are more confident while descending, but it's okay. Just gotta stay near this group on the wheel, and once we hit the flat part, I gotta be in the group just to make sure I'm not fighting with the crosswinds alone. The descent is pretty easy, I would say. It's not very technical, however you have to be concentrated and focused, especially in the situation where the cars are standing on the left side of the road and waiting for you to pass. Also, the road is not perfect, it's a bit shaky sometimes, but if you are running tubeless, you are pretty comfortable, I would say. During this downhill I managed to hit almost 82 kilometers per hour, which is pretty awesome. Comment down below what was the highest speed you managed to hit on bicycle, also state the place where you did it. Let's see who is faster. This is pretty funny moment over here. I'm trying to pedal while going 80 k's per hour. The cadence, as you can see, 130 revolutions per minute. We are getting closer to the flat and windy part of the stage. Couple of switchbacks, and I'm desperately trying to stay on this guy's wheel, hitting almost 600 watts, sprinting out of the saddle, and still no luck. You can see he's just flying in front of me, and the gap is around 50 to 100 meters. But I tried, and let's see if I manage actually to stay with this group in front of me. I think actually that this may be the most enjoyable downhill of Tour de Cartonnen, and I will tell you why. First of all, the road quality is pretty good, as for Austria, I would say. Second of all, the road is pretty straight, so there are no turns. If you're a good descender, you can hit here around 70 to 80, even sometimes I think 90 kilometers per hour. Just make sure you do it when the road is very dry. This is one of the crucial moments on the stage. You could see there was the speed limit sign of 50 kilometers per hour. Of course, I'm not even thinking about it. I'm sprinting over here, hitting almost 900 watts. Now this guy is aggressively overtaking me, sprinting from my wheel in order to bridge across to the group that is in front of us. I am struggling over here, hitting 400-500 watts just to make sure I don't lose these guys as well. It may seem that I almost closed the gap, but what happens right now? There is another gap opening between these two guys and the group ahead of us. So I am catching my breath here for 2-3 seconds and I gotta sprint again in order to finally close this gap between me and the group in front of me. It wasn't easy, however, I had to do it, and you can see that my heart rate spiked up to almost 180 beats per minute, but it was really worth it because we had around 18 kilometers of crosswind section ahead of us, and during that section you gotta pray that you are in the group, otherwise you may lose a lot of time. This is the second climb of the day, which is called Zlan. The distance is 6.2 kilometers long and the total elevation gain is 215 meters. The average gradient, as Strava says, is 3%. I averaged around 200 watts during this climb, made it in 16 minutes and 20 seconds, and as you can see, the average heart rate here is pretty high, around 172, 173 beats per minute. So I am already getting cooked over here big time. I try to keep my cadence as high as possible over here, around 85 to 95 RPMs. However, I had sometimes to get up from the saddle and do it on my legs, because sometimes it's pretty hard to keep yourself in the saddle during such long climbs, which have a duration of 15, 20, 30 or more minutes. So sometimes it's a good idea to change the position from spinning in the saddle with the high cadence and using the low cadence while riding out of the saddle. So this is actually the last descent before the crosswind section, and as you can see, I'm trying my best, keeping up with the group in front of me. Not perfect, but not bad, I think. The quality of the road here is perfect. It's a bit curvy, however, again, you can still maintain pretty high speeds over here. While you're watching this descent, it will be highly appreciated if you subscribe to this channel if you like the content. Also, don't forget to like this video, it really helps the channel to grow and to get more views. Also, don't forget about the notification bell, it does really help you to be on top of all the videos, new videos that I post. Also, don't forget that you can subscribe to my Facebook page. Just send me a friend request. Subscribe to me on Instagram. I do post stories every day regarding my trainings, just personal life, some funny stuff, some backstage moments of the races and life itself, so will be highly appreciated as well. Moreover, in case you have any questions regarding my training, regarding the races that I'm gonna attend, for example in 2020, regarding my bike gear I use, don't hesitate, write me a message, comment this video, write me on Facebook, hit me in Instagram, wherever you can, I will be happy to help you and answer your questions. You can see that I lost the wheel of the guy in front of me over here, so I had to hit almost 900 watts and keep 500 watts for like 20 or 30 seconds, and finally I managed to stay on his wheel, close this gap, and this is actually the moment where I got to the group and stayed with the group during the crosswind sections. This is a good example of how not to do in the group that is rotating. The group has to work perfectly and don't let any gaps opening. I was not really into working with this group because I was pretty cooked and I am skinny. This rotation stuff is not for me, because 2-3 turns and I'm done. Therefore, I was leaving a small gap in front of me to let the guys rotate, and I would just sit on the wheel and do nothing. In most cases, it's pretty bad because other people are working and you're just sitting doing nothing. However, sometimes you don't need to work, especially when you are cooked. In that case, you're not breaking the pace that is set by the group and everybody is actually more happy than when you are trying to take your turns and you go too hard, for example, or too slow and you break the perfect rotation of the group. So this actually how it works. And here we are, the last climb of the day. This is actually Bad Bleiberg and the total distance is 7.2 kilometers. The elevation gain is 431 meters. Average gradient is 6%. I climbed a little bit over 26 minutes over here and this is pretty hard climbs. It's pretty long. Sometimes the gradient goes up to 20, even maybe 22-23%. This is one of the steepest parts of this climb and you can see it from my cadence, for example, because it goes down to almost 50 RPMs. The heart rate is 174, which is pretty high considering the fourth day of racing. The gradient is 14%. This is what Garmin shows, but I'm sure that it's more. And the speed is just crazy. It's 9 kilometers per hour. So everybody is grinding, everybody is suffering, and this is actually, this switchback over here has the highest gradient maybe I ever ridden. It's really, really epic. Also, this was the place where I got dropped finally from the group that I was with before, and after that I was left with a couple of guys, like this guy from Team Moviso and also another guy on my right side. This is the guy from Team Physio. So we were working together till the finish and tried to play out some sprint games, and I was, I think, second. We will see in a bit. I was familiar with this finish because last year we had the same stage with the same track. Therefore, I knew that I had to be fourth or third wheel in the last 200 meters and then just try to do a full gas sprint and try to win from the group of four or five riders. Last 200 meters, I am fourth wheel. However, I had to be at least third wheel over here because the guy in pink socks, he is cooked. He is letting this gap open between the third and first wheel in this case, and we simply have no time to close this gap. And you can see that I had to overtake him on the right, and I also didn't have legs to close the gap in front of me. So this is the way we finished this race. I sprinted for 136th place in the general classification and 67th in my age category. So after this stage, overall I am 123rd and in category 64th. So I did climb a bit higher than the previous race, which is pretty good. Thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to subscribe and like this video, and I see you in the next video. Bye bye.